Boom! Boom, 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 boom! All right, as you can tell, it is Monday, as there's a distinct lack thereof of beard. And it's time for the barin! But not champagne, because it's rosewater, and I hate rosewater as I hate hell, all Montagues, and thee. Have thee, coward. I should whip out my sword. My actual sword, I'm not gonna, that isn't a euphemism for anything. This is public broadcasting. This is Bahrain. It's a Monday night, I'm a bit tired, but this is the only time I can literally put this into the internet before I go completely insane and the week just overtakes me and then it's Friday and I'm like, oh, that happened. One thing I've learned this weekend, don't predict Formula One, because if you forget to predict, you win, you're in the lead, and if you do predict, then you fall down to like fourth. Yeah, not happy about that, but, you know, room for improvement. It's a marathon, not a sprint, but I've always been a very good sprinter and a crap marathon runner. So, shows what I suspected, that I am useless as predicting, and it's annoying, but room for improvement. But Bahrain, question one. This is for Formula, by the way, just in case you... who's performed most impressed you in the Bahrain Grand Prix? Esteban Gutierrez by a mile, because not only did he get rolled over, he restrained getting out of the car and finding Pastor Maldonado and frankly lamping him. So his performance most impressed me. But on a serious note, no, I think that's the most serious note I can get. It's just outrageous. But no, tapes rolling, other halves watching, I have to be sensible. Because she will not forgive me if I just spend the next 10 minutes besmiting Pastor Maldonado, much as I'd like to. Most impressed performance? Probably, I don't know, Max Chilton, because he's really consistent and just really annoying, but he doesn't really get anybody's way. I'll put this clipper over there, because it's going to click the whole time. Why am I literally red? As you can see, my brain's all frazzled. Even more so than normal. Maybe Rosberg, not for lamping Hamilton at the end of the race. Yeah, I mean, I don't think someone's performance impressed me. There wasn't anything that, like, a standout that I want to, like, kind of promote or lament. Sergio Perez, but we know Force India's a good, quick car. I think maybe... I think whose performance most impressed me today in Bahrain were teammates, because there was a lot of battles and a lot of fair racing during the race, and that can only happen if, I don't know, you're scared of your team principals, so maybe team principals most impressed me today, because they have the respect of their drivers. Question two, out of each engine supply, which team's performance is impressing you over the most races, over 1 to 3 this season? To be honest, I had to Google this, I had to work out who's got what engine. Right, Ferrari, it's got to be toss between Sauber and Moose. Because Moose are consistent. But not Jules, because Jules, like, crashes into people a bit too often in Bahrain for my life. Sauber, because Sauber are beige, but consistently beige. Suto has been alright in the first couple of races, not so much in Bahrain. And Ferrari, as Mr. Sotheby said, with his Jamaican Jev and his Robot Wars quote, if, you know, you can't really, yes, Ferrari doing well, but you can't really say they're doing really well because they're like 9th and 10th, and it's Ferrari with a Ferrari engine and a Ferrari designed car all in-house. Look at what Mercedes have done with all in-house. apologies, I am a bit groggy and a bit, like, dead to the world at the moment. I'm currently dosed up on many, many pills, which is why my head's like, and this eye's not working really well. Okay, who are, what other engine suppliers we've got? Renault! I bet the guys in Ivry are pretty peeved, to be honest. They've made an absolute shocker. With that question, it has to be Red Bull, because Red Bull... Adrian Newey has gone, good package, and then realised that the engine is utterly useless. So he's seemingly redesigned the car in its entirety, and it's now, you know, you look at Ricciardo in Australia, but we knew it was cheating. But then you look at Ricardo and Vettel in Bahrain, they were doing some good stuff. I think Red Bull for me. Sorry. Renault. Who else supplies engines? Mercedes. Williams. Are Williams Mercedes powered? This is where I've got to work this out. Mercia, Lotus, Scuderia. Williams. Yes, Williams Martini Racing. Good times. Oh wait, questions. Williams. Everyone says Mercedes. No, because Mercedes aren't the best Mercedes powered engine. Because they were designed, it was specifically designed. The F1 team effectively designed the engine. So of course they're going to be stonkingly good, which they are. But for a team to not have designed the engine, such as Williams, doing so well, despite that, I think is deserving of more credit than having built it in-house from scratch. Just made that sort of thing. Are there any more engine suppliers? This is where I've got to like work this out. Renault Ferrari. Nope, good. Okay, cool. That answers question two, does it? Question three. We've seen 10 years of F1 in Bahrain, have we? Blimey. Which race has been your favourite and why? Well, maybe there was Tea Towel Gate in 2005. Maybe when Alonso won in 2012, I can't remember. See, I haven't written anything. No, in fact, I've written anything on the back of my hand. No, I haven't. I just wanted to wave at you. Hello. I think when Alonso won his first race for Ferrari, when Bahrain was like first on the calendar, I think that was a really good race. Maybe when the Alien Invasion in 2007, that was brilliant. Such excitement in the middle of the race. Brought out like 5 safety cars all in one go, and I was just like, this is amazing. But of course, the obvious solution is today is 2014, because I think it worked better under the lights. It had a kind of like a Qatar MotoGP feel to it, which I always like. And because it was just, you know, good racing, and it brought out good racing. And that's what we all want to see. You know, hello and welcome to you that have jumped on the Formula One bandwagon for 2014, given your, you know, anger and frankly misjudged and misguided idiocy to say that Formula One is useless and you don't like the sound of the engines and it's rubbish. Well, hello and welcome to, like, the real world, when we're all here and enjoying the Formula One. So glad you can join us, and come gather around and, you know, have a pint and a Jaffa cake and we'll all watch the rest of the season together in harmony. So, yeah, I'd probably say this race because it was just so much better than all the other ones. And I can't go back through history because I don't remember what happened in Australia, let alone Bahrain last year, let alone like Bahrain 9 or 10 years ago. So I'll just say this year to be safe. Bonus question, favourite race battle today and why? Pastor Maldonado against the world. Sort of a legend. No, because my other half is like scowling into the screen right now. I'm sorry, Vicky, I'm sorry. So probably not Maldonado against Gutierrez. That's a sideshow to the main event. To me, it wasn't really a battle. To me, my favourite race battle that wasn't a battle, I should probably put it in brackets, like an album cover. A battle that wasn't a battle. Was Daniel Ricciardo overtaking or being told to overtake Sebastian Vettel and Sebastian Vettel being told to bugger off out of the way. Multi 31 happened. And my goodness me, it was amazing and it's just so beautiful. I don't know. The battle between like my head and my mouth when the picture of Natalie Pinkham wearing Jensen Button's 250 t-shirt that my other half sent me. Maybe that was my favourite battle of the race. But yeah, I think Vettel and Ricciardo, because you know the obvious one is Hamilton and Rosberg, but they're expected to do that. So yeah, I think the unpredictable and the mad was my favourite. So yes, that's 10 minutes of your life. We won't get back. Really sorry. You probably stopped this moons ago. So hello if you haven't. See you all potentially in 2 weeks when we have the Chinese Grand Prix from Shanghai, which will be brilliant because Shanghai is a brilliant city, a brilliant track, and hopefully I will have like a partner in crime here with me, and we'll do it together. So it'll be Easter bunnies, chocolate, and China. So I hope you can join us then. But from me and my invisible at the moment, like playing like an invisible harp. Good night from us. Look after yourselves. I always say that, and I always mean it. Especially Gutierrez. you know, silliness aside. Catch you later. Look after yourselves, and go and be good.